The album's called Folie à Deux, and it's French for the shared madness of two, which is a psychological term for basically two independently crazy individuals making each other even exponentially crazier. For me, the record is kind of a big commentary on just this malaise, this indifference in American culture right now. So the title's kind of a play on not necessarily two individual, you know, people being crazy, but just the way you have the audience and the supplier of pop culture being entertainers, you know, sports figures, even politicians or whatever, right, have just gotten sucked into this whole thing. And people want them to be crazier, and they get crazier. And it's just this cycle of just ridiculousness. We wanted to kind of surprise people and come out with this record and have it pretty much done before anyone really knew about it. And in order to accomplish that, we pretty much set this very kind of harsh goal for ourselves as far as completing it. It's a much better record because of how much stress there was and how much we fought on it, but it's our broadest record where it has a statement and every part of it is relating to the statement. Right now, our culture is very built on having things, and it's not really built on any experiences. You know, I mean, it's not really built on knowing anything or really feeling anything. It's built on having something. And the song kind of came out of that, of just a commentary on that, how stupid that is. So it's, I don't care, but it's, you know, like an anthem, like something that you sing along to, but that's not something you want to sing along to. That's not an idea that you really want. You know, that's not what you want on a bumper sticker. That's not like something you want to express to your friends and family. So I think there's commentary in that. There's something really ironic about that, about how big and grandiose it sounds. We just wanted it to be as big and like epic sounding as it could for such a petty and little feeling.
People would probably easily assume that this song is just about a relationship, but I don't necessarily think that is what it means. I think it's kind of can serve as an analogy for other things. Just for, again, to the pop culture reference of, like, you know, it's here for America's Sweethearts, but not really, you know what I'm saying? Like, you only want to hear about, like, you know, people's skeletons in their closet and kind of rejoice in it.
This is my favorite album packaging we've ever done. We had some really brilliant people working on him, and it has come out so great.
We're big fans of an artist named Luke Chu, and we just gave him, you know, the title and some of the ideas we had behind the record, and he went there with it. I think it leaves it up to a lot of people's imaginations to figure out what it means, which is cool.
We're very happy with it. It's obviously going to confuse some people, but it's all right. I think one of the goals with this record is that if you just want a record that you can dance to or whatever, or just sing along to, that it's there. You know, that it's still, at the end of the day, just a quality, you know, fun record. But we're kind of just curious with the idea of music as a means of inciting emotion and music with purpose rather than it just being, you know, hey, that's a good song, that's catchy. We're older and we want to express a little bit more in there too. So there's a lot more to read into in the music this time.